I want to invite up to the stage Bridget Luther. Where are you, Bridget? Great. Of Cradle to Cradle Products Innovative Institute. What is the challenge that Bridget's bringing before CGI and that I hope many people will focus on and get involved in? We're looking at more than 100,000 man-made chemicals used in industrial processes, many of which are known to be toxic to humans, to animals, and to plant life. These chemicals are present in our household products, and when disposed of, they eventually make their way into our natural ecosystems. Most companies continue to experience three problems when it comes to waste management. One, they do not design with the end use in mind. Two, they design their products that are less bad, but not great, and not restorative or beneficial to people and the planet. And three, they lack the resources in the first place to reformulate or redesign their products. The Institute is poised and positioned to address these challenges in waste management by assessing water purity, renewable energy, and social fairness involved in a product's manufacturing process. As such, Cradle to Grave ensures that products are reincarnated and go back to the cradle and not to the grave. How they are addressing it, keeping those products out of the grave, so to speak. The Cradle to Cradle Products Innovation Institute commits to creating an open innovation platform for positive product development. By 2015, the Institute will certify 1,000 products with the Cradle to Cradle standard, and they'll train at least 100 professionals to evaluate using their methodology. Beginning with Shaw Industries, the world's largest carbon manufacturer, the Steelcase, the world's largest office furniture manufacturer, this commitment is poised to change the way the world does business. The commitment will allow us to reduce toxic chemicals, toxic materials worldwide by 300,000 tons and transition away from dangerous products towards products that are made intelligently and which contribute to a socially just, strong economy and a healthy world. To Bridget, our congratulations.